We're here in Paris for UNESCO conference. I feel excited as to what we'll be doing. I feel slightly unsure as to exactly what we're doing. All I know now is that we will be giving a 5-minute presentation and we will be meeting various different government officials and various different youth groups from around the world, which I do find extremely exciting. But at the minute, I am unsure as to how it will go, as to, you know, the kind of logistics of it. But as I say, it's really exciting. I think it'll be an amazing experience by the end.
Well, I'm actually quite shy, so I really want to, like, you know, push myself and like try and build up my confidence and stuff and like challenge myself. Because even when I had to do the interview to come to Paris, like I was reconsidering not doing it because it was an interview, and I don't like do well with stuff like that. So I thought I would, like, you know, go for it anyway because there's nothing to lose. So I challenged myself to do that, and you know, I'm coming here. So, and about the presentation as well. So I don't want to do it, but I'm going to do it because, you know, I want to achieve like confidence and stuff from it. So.
The best bit of the whole Paris trip so far, I'm trying to stop myself from saying the food. When we first went into the conference suite, seeing the kind of, I don't know, for me it was just kind of seeing the microphones, the stage, and I'm just imagining it being full of people. That was really exciting.
So we welcome your thinking and your contributions through this youth forum, and particularly how you feel we should be developing transformative policy, working with youth through education, formal and non-formal.
However, I would argue that participation is not a goal in itself. It's a means to a goal. Participation for what? And what part of our role here in the coming few days is to think about how that gets played out among ourselves as colleagues, in partnerships with youth online, in partnerships with ministers, with academics, and with funders.
On issues that we care about, then issues that matter to us, whether it's local issues, issues within our area, national issues, or anything like that.
My favourite part of today was meeting Gordon Brown and hopefully securing an interview with him. I should have gotten it, so I better hold up to his word. He's very angry.
Well, I have to do a presentation, which I'm really terrified about because I don't like speaking in front of people. I'm not really great at that.
We will be doing a 5-minute presentation, which I only found out about when we got here. I'm excited about it because it's something that I love doing, but I'm extremely nervous also because it is in front of very high profile figures from across the world, from different youth groups, with different, you know, with different kinds of people, with people from across the world, as I say. So it is a daunting task. It is something that I, at the minute, I'm extremely nervous for, and that I need to do a lot more kind of preparation for. But it's something that when I get up and I do it, I will be extremely nervous, but I will love doing it. That's what I love doing.
Slightly nervous at the minute. I think it's because something kind of got real, but. No, I'm excited as well because, as I say, this is the kind of thing I relish. I love doing this, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
It won't. It's like a poem. Read it.
Read it slowly. You'll be grand.
So let's we first start with the young people. Give them a hand of applause, please.
My name is Shauneen and I am part of Wimps, which stands for Where's My Public Servant? Wimps is a project of the organisation Public Achievement in Northern Ireland. We believe that young people have the right to hold those in positions of power to account. Our project involves getting young people into the world of filmmaking, journalism, politics, working on issues that we are concerned about. At Wimps, we have the opportunity to identify and email our own politicians.
Sorry about this.
holiday.
We also interview them. We can write for our own website, wimps.tv, to express our own opinions and even campaign for our beliefs, like securing votes at 16 in Northern Ireland, or tackling human rights abuses by armed organisations. It enables us to get involved in issues that really affect us. We are widely involved in using social media as we believe that everyone is connected through it. It allows us to share our own opinions with others so they can get involved too. We aim to make it normal for young people to get in touch with and talk to their local political representatives and get involved in bringing change to our society.
Thank you, Shauneen. Bonjour, je m'appelle Robert. Hello, my name is Robert, and unfortunately that's the height of my French for today. I'm going to tell you a bit about what my personal involvement in WIMPS and what it has done for me. My first major experience came through my interest in the future of education. I watched the Minister of Education for Northern Ireland, John O'Dowd, on television talking about closing and amalgamating schools in my area of Belfast. He mentioned speaking to trade unions, to parents, to teachers and to the Catholic Church. The one group of people he failed to mention were young people. I was quite angry at this, and so I used Twitter and contacted him. And to my surprise, he contacted me back and responded. He actually offered us an interview. It was my first interview with a politician. When I found out, it was a mixed bag of emotions, excitement, shock, nerve, that a politician had actually asked if I wanted to interview him. My next big opportunity with WIMPS was a really big one. Public Achievement won a big society award from the British Prime Minister. I was selected with another WIMPS activist to attend an evening reception in 10 Downing Street, hosted by the Prime Minister, David Cameron. I was very fortunate enough, I got to speak to him about WIMPS and even managed to ask him for an interview. We are waiting confirmation for a date. My latest and perhaps greatest experience is being here today, addressing this conference. I have always had opinions, but WIMPS has given me a focus and an outlet to express my opinion, to let my voice be heard as it should. WIMPS has helped me to discover a passion for politics and broadcast journalism. Our motto is, where passion meets action. That's what it's done for me. My passion has been met with action. WIMPS is paving the way for my future and has given me new hopes and ambitions and made me realise I can do whatever I want. The sky is the limit. I think this has been possible because WIMPS is an extremely unique youth organisation. In post-conflict Northern Ireland, WIMPS provides a shared space where young people of all social and political backgrounds are free to express their opinions and their thoughts. There are times when opinions will clash, that we will disagree, but we understand that not everyone is going to agree with us. It's about mutual respect. We have to respect each other. And ultimately, we have a common goal, the rights of young people, to let young people's voices be heard. It is rare where I live to get such an amazing opportunity.
I first heard about WIMPS from my politics class, and I went to the workshops to find out what it was about. For me, it brought the subject of politics to life as I got involved in the subject I was learning about. WIMPS has given me so many opportunities, and I am grateful for it because before I started, I was really shy. Through interviewing people, I've developed my social skills and my confidence. I love filmmaking, learning about the different styles of films, and recently even directing my own short film on Culture Night in Belfast. But the thing I'm grateful for the most is the fact that WIMPS has given me the motivation to challenge myself to do things I wouldn't normally do. For this trip, I had to do an interview, and I was reconsidering not even trying, but I thought that was just too easy, and I wanted to at least prove to myself that I could achieve stuff. This presentation was a challenge for me. When I first heard about it, I was so frightened about public speaking in front of so many people. But I thought I should do this. It's a great opportunity to prove that I can do this if I push myself, and after I can say I've done it and be proud of myself. WIMPS has also Wimps also allows us to follow our own interests. Currently, I am starting my own project about trying to get more women into politics. We have very few women in our assembly, in our councils, and even in Westminster Parliament. I want to know why and what we can do to change this. So I'm doing a mini-series of interviews with women and men in politics so that young people can get better understanding of these issues.
Well, that is it from us. Also, don't forget that we do have a website, www.wimps.tv. Please do check it out if you get a chance. So, just, again, a big thank you and merci beaucoup. The conference has gone really well over the last 2 days. Today is unfortunately the last day. I feel myself, I have learned a lot about how we can develop as a youth group, how other youth groups throughout the world, how they develop and how we can learn from them and how we have learned from them and how they have learned from us. The feedback that we have been getting from those various youth groups and from the ministers and from, you know, the distinguished guests at the conference has been phenomenal. After we did our presentation on Tuesday, people have been coming up to us and saying that we're natural and have been really, really complimentary to us. People seem very interested in the work that we do. We have a lot of people from across many different backgrounds, from media backgrounds, from political backgrounds, from, you know, charity backgrounds, that seem really interested in our work. Hopefully out of this what we can get is more connections worldwide, hopefully a few trips, a few more trips even.
I'm feeling really good about it, but I'm really kind of sad that it's the last day because I really enjoyed myself. I think it's been a really amazing experience. I've met lots of new people and stuff, and just it's been really, really good. I think I've kind of pushed myself as well to do stuff like the presentation. Well, before the presentation, I was really, really nervous, and then when I kind of got up, I was so nervous. Like, I really thought I was gonna just faint or something. It was really terrible, so it was. But after, it was such a relief, like, just. And then the response that I got from everyone was just, I just couldn't believe it. Like, I didn't expect anyone to do that, so they were coming up to me and saying, like, well done and stuff, and we're just really happy that I did it and stuff. So.